Sitaram, my name is Kevin Das, and I will be the MC for this week's episode of Prem Bhakti Ki Awaaz. We will now have an opening prayer done by Davinja Biharilal.
Om Ramaya Rama Bhatraya Ramachandraya Vedase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Nama Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Prem Soshir Ramachandra Bhagawan Ki Jai.
Now we'll have a Gita slog done by Sanjay Takardeen, followed by a song done by Priya Singh.
Sitaram, everybody. Lord Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Yada yada hi dharmasya ganeya bhavati bharata abhyuttanam adharmasya taratmanam shijamyaham. Whenever there is decline of dharma and rise of a dharm, I manifest myself as an embodied being. Jai Sitaram.
Thank you.
This week's Pravachan will be delivered by Pandit Dhaneshwar Sharma, also known as Pandit Rishi.
Vakratunda Mahakaya Surya Kote Sama Prabha Nirvignam Kurume Deva Sarvakayeshu Sarvada Dhyanamulam Guru Murti Pujamulam Guru Param Mantramulam Guru Vakyam Mokshamulam Guru Kripa Hari Om Shantihi 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 Hari Om. Dear viewers, lovers and worshippers of the Lord, this evening, as through the medium of electronic television and such medium in which we communicate as we pray, it is my hope, as through your television set this evening, we will together communicate with the Lord. And in this sense, as we communicate, it is through the medium of our mind. And we as human beings are very exception to all Bhagwans and God, 8.4 million of species of life in which he have created. And in Bhagavad Gita, in the 9th chapter, the 29th verse, Bhagavan Sri Krishna said to Arjuna, and on this note, as the Lord speaks to Arjuna in a most definite way, he's also communicating with us. And he said to Arjuna, Samoham sarvabhuteshu Name dvesho sena prayaha ye bhajanti tu mam bhaktya maite techu chapyaham. Arjuna, I am present in all. None is an exception. For him who recognizes me of such and him who dearly worship me, I stand by his side. My loving devotees, when sometimes we face challenges and we face difficulties and we face that which sometimes suppresses life, we ask ourselves, where is this God or Bhagwan we pray to? And in the similar outskirt in Ramchritamanas, when Ravana was doing the sad thing, causing pain and havoc, the devotees at that time, they were asked if Mother Earth, she took the form of a cow. They all together in disguised form went to Brahma Devata, and where can they find Vishnu Bhagwan? And in similar manner too, we ask ourselves, where can we find God when all these challenges is placed before us? But my friends, Bhagwan Shiva spoke to the Devatas at that time. He says, Hari Vyapaka Sarvatra Samana. Tell me where you know the Lord do not reside. And if you tell me where the Lord do not reside, then I will tell you where he resides. He says, Ansa Jivana Avinashi. He is present in all living beings. None of us is an exception. But Prema Tu Pragat. But him who have love for me in his mind, only him recognize me. And that is the key ingredients in which the Lord wants from us. He wants our love, my friends. Even the flowers, the fruits, the offering, all we make, they are the fruits of Mother Nature. But what is the reality of our offering is the thought in which we entertain in this mind, the act of the offering and how we make the offering. Because if you look at all the source of all the offering, from the fruits, the flowers, and even every other thing we make offering, they are a product of Mother Nature and that in which others help. But a real offering from you is that from the mind. That's why Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna, I am present in all. And this should be our take-home message for this evening. None of us is an exception thinking God does not love us. We are all his children. He loves us, he hates us not. But the way we come unto him, that's how he reveals himself to us. As to the measure of the love and the devotion the devotee propels, that's how the Lord is magneted to his life. this evening, my brothers and sisters and friends. It is my hope that our mind, our thought, is what brings us closer to God. And in said Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna, in the 9th chapter, and the final verse of the 9th chapter, he said to Arjuna, of this mind, my friends, our mind is one of the most powerful. It may not be seen physically as a part of the body, yet it is one of the most powerful assets. And in the 9th chapter, the 34th verse, the Lord said to Arjuna, O Arjuna, manmana bhava mada bhaktyo namaje mam namaskurum mameva shase yukta veva matmanam matparayanaha. Arjuna, submit your mind unto me. Be devoted to me, worship me, be obeisance unto me. And thinking of me and linking yourself and depending upon me, I stand by your side. What did Bhagavan say? He said to submit your mind. Although we make our offerings of all the offering of, he says, patra, pushpa, palam, of fruit, flower, leaf, etc. But the more and the key ingredients is the mind with bhakti. Yome bhakti. With bhakti, bhakti comes from within the in-core of our mind. And my friends, for us really to understand the mind, we should take a look at an analogy. Taking the sea, for example, as the mind, at the bottom of the ocean is this huge body of water containing salt. But yet, as we come on top, the wave, as it crashes into the water and on the bank of the river, salt still exists within the water. But the water at the bottom of the ocean takes a different form from that which is on the level. And if we to go beyond that, on the level of the wave, we'll find foam or salt spray. There, water is present, but in a different form with the salt of the water. And if the water continues to transcend, you will find also to the water as it evaporates, changing in from a liquid and goes further upward, it becomes water vapor. But as the water vapor continues to rise, you find the status of a change, and when it attains that of gas in the atmosphere, salt from which the water is not present, but from the ocean up into the sky, the same water is present on a different level, on a different form. Likewise, that's the mind. At the bottom of the ocean may be the mind at the extreme end. At the middle, on the foam, may be the mind at the middle. And way on top, as water vapor exists as gas, where the mind can be one closer to God. And we are in control of this mind of ours. That's why the Lord says in this part of the Gita, O Arjuna, let your mind be submitted unto me. And the mind is so powerful that on one side it can be very extreme. Water exists at the bottom of the ocean, but it exists in a different form. And on the other extreme, it exists in water vapor, way up into the atmosphere in the sky, in the purest form where water is present, cannot be seen, neither can the soul be tasted within that vapor. That's where the mind becomes connected with God. And on the middle mind, that is where the mind is like a crow, as Sai Baba says, the mind becomes like a crow when he gets involved too much in this world. He looked into one direction a moment, then the other moment, he looks into the other direction. Where do we want to fall into these three categories? You are in control. And so this evening, it is my hope, through the medium of Bhagavad Gita, and through the medium of your intellect, you will be able to get closer to God. As water rises to different levels and attain this vapor state, in the purest form in the atmosphere, that also precipitates. In that way also, our mind can become one with God, allowing not the mind to be like the water at the bottom of the ocean contaminated with the salt, but allowing that of which the mind become a pure state. And Bhagavan tells of us, Arjuna, that is the mind he won from the devotee. And the devotee who offered to him his mind and thus entertained with the Lord thoughts within, that devotee become near and dear to me. My loving brothers and sisters and friends, When we face challenges and difficulty, and we may face stumbling blocks or hurdles to cross in life, it doesn't mean God does not love us. It is only when we are placed with certain challenges, then the true and beauty, strength, and character of us come to life. And this evening, it is my hope that your mind will be the medium in which you can communicate with our Lord. Is our mind is where all our intuitive powers are there and within. And so we pray and ask Bhagwan, with such mind as our intuitive power, such mind we communicate with Him, that's the mind in which we link our thoughts with Him. And it's only through our mind, and in the mind in the purest state, that's why He says in Bhagavad Gita, your mind is your friend and your mind is your enemy. And sometimes the ordinary man or the ordinary being may think, how can the mind be your friend and how can the mind be your enemy? When we entertain thought of hatred, of jealousy, of infatuation, of all the vices, wanting to commit acts that hurt others, definitely your mind becomes your enemy. And when we entertain the thought of love and peace and prosperity, and entertain the thought of wanting to do good, the thought of which are virtuous in nature, the mind becomes your friend. Your friend in which it gives positive thoughts. And when our thoughts are positive, our actions are positive. And when our actions are positive, we only receive our fruit of our action, which is that is good. So this evening, it is my hope with your thoughts, and the thought is what is where everything starts from. As the great poet Wayne Dyer says, everything starts with a thought. And this thought comes from within our mind. Everything in the world we do starts with a thought. And that's what makes human beings be so special than all other Bhagwans or God's creation. Why? Because He blessed us not with an instinct, but He blessed us with a mind. And this is the mind which you and I, this is the mind which all living human beings have, in such empowering situation that makes Him special, this mind. And this is the mind tonight He's saying, Bhagwan is saying to Arjuna, submit this mind unto me, give your mind unto me, and everything would be great.
For all your video and photography needs, invitations, digital albums, studio portraits, and much more, they're professionals in the business since 1980. Catering for all your wedding ceremonies, receptions, sweet 16s, parties, and much, much more. You can contact them at 718-843-1668.
Planning that special getaway? Pan American Travel and Tours can surely help. Whether it's a flight to your favorite hotspots around the world or that dream cruise you've been thinking of, we have the lowest fares in town. Visit us at 12209 Liberty Avenue on the second floor, or you can call Ina Prasad at 718-848-0000. Tax time is here, and we're equipped with a competent staff to service all your tax and insurance needs. Again, visit us in the heart of Richmond Hill, 12209 Liberty Avenue, on the second floor, or call Ina Prasad at 718-848-0000. Looking for luxurious homes or apartments? Visit Zara with two convenient locations, 16607 Hillside Avenue, Jamaica, Queens, New York, 11432. Their telephone number is 718-415-8833. Second location is 451 Fulton Avenue, Hempstead, Long Island, New York, 11550. Their telephone number is 516-292-6071. They have studios, 1, 2, and 3 bedrooms, furnished or unfurnished, with short or long-term leases available. Call for an appointment today to see these luxurious apartments. Again, Zara Luxury Apartment and Homes, with two locations, servicing New York. 718-415-8833 or 516-292-6.
As some of you know, our very own Panaji Narayan Lachana and a few executives of the Prem Bhakti Mandir led a trip all the way to Austin, Texas this past weekend. And seeing that we have Panaji here today, would you like to share some of your experiences with us?
Yes, Teresa G. It was an extraordinary trip. We had visited the Radha Madhav Dham temple, well known as Barsana Dham. We will feature a few clips. A special word of thank you to all those who join us to make that trip a grand successful one. Our next trip coming up to Texas also in September. Please make your phone call to make your reservation. Radhe, Radhe. Now, fellow brothers and sisters, viewers, we are here in Texas visiting here the Barsana Dham. It's a special place for pilgrimage worshiping. It's a beautiful scene here, and you can see the background here. We have all of these are the devotees from various temples joining with us here at Prem Bhakti Mandir on this beautiful trip for the first time ever in Texas. And so I would like to congratulate all those who came out here to enjoy this wonderful experience of pilgrimage. It's a beautiful morning here. Today is Saturday, and we are here just viewing the around the temple. This morning we had a satsang at 6:30 to from 6:30 to 7:30, after which we had a breakfast. So I want to thank all those who came out here to enjoy this beautiful experience here at Austin, Texas. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Radhe Radhe, Radhe Radhe, Radhe Radhe.
Cleaning, specializing in residential and commercial buildings, hydrojet cleaning service, video camera inspection, sewer and water main repairs. You can contact Mike at 718-657-7235 or 347-401-3831. Central Auto Repairs and Body Shop, Complete Car Care Center, New York State Inspection, Mufflers, Brakes, Air Conditioning, General Repair, Complete Body and Fender Work, Painting, Insurance Appraisals. Contact Dave at 718-738-2252 or 718-322-1400. Law Office of Rajesh Subhai, located at 110-10 Jamaica Avenue in Richmond Hill, Queens, New York, offers professional, reliable, and reasonably priced legal services. Rajesh Subhai has over 10 years of experience in all real estate transactions, landlord and tenant disputes, immigration, bankruptcy, mortgage foreclosure, and modification. Contact Bhai Subhai at 718-925-89.
We will have a final bhajan done by Movina C. Prasad.
जो तू मिटाना चाहे जीवन के कृष्णा जो तू मिटाना चाहे जीवन के कृष्णा सुबह शाम बोल बंदे कृष्णा 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 सुबह शाम बोल बंदे कृष्णा 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 जो तू मिटाना चाहे जीवन की कृष्णा जो तू मिटाना चाहे जीवन की कृष्णा सुबह शाम बोल बंदे कृष्णा 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 सुबह शाम बोल बंदे कृष्णा 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 नाम पावन पावन कृष्ण नाम प्यारा प्यारा जो ना बोले कृष्णा कृष्णा जग में वो हारा हारा कृष्ण नाम पावन पावन कृष्ण नाम प्यारा प्यारा जो ना बोले कृष्णा कृष्णा जग में वो हारा हारा मन का मिटे अंधियारा बोले कृष्णा कृष्णा मन का मिटे अंधियारा बोले कृष्णा कृष्णा सुबह शाम बोल बने कृष्णा 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 सुबह शाम बोल बंदे कृष्णा 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 जिसको मिले ना पेरा सुख कामरम क्या जाने जो ना जाए कृष्णा कृष्णा नित का डरम क्या माने जिसको मिले ना पेरा सुख कामरम क्या जाने जो ना जाए कृष्णा कृष्णा नित का डरम क्या माने चाहे अगर उजियारा बोले कृष्णा कृष्णा चाहे अगर उजियारा बोले कृष्णा कृष्णा सुबह शाम बोल बने कृष्णा 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 सुबह शाम बोल बने कृष्णा 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 जो तू मिटाना चाहे जीवन की कृष्णा जो तू मिटाना चाहे जीवन की कृष्णा सुबह शाम बोल बने कृष्णा 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 सुबह शाम बोल बने कृष्णा कृष्णा कृष्णा
नमस्ते. It's that time once again for this week's birthday greetings. Today is very special, seeing as it's our very own little princess, Haley Prasad's birthday. Greetings are coming from your parents, Lorna and Terry, and your beloved brothers, Vishal and Varun. We wish you a very, very happy birthday with many more to come. We can't forget, greetings are also coming from your sisters of the Natya Mohini Dance Academy and all of us here at Prem Bhakti Mandir. May God continue to shower His richest blessings upon you, and you will always be successful in life. J.C. Tara.
Coming to Prem Bhakti Mandir, I have learned many things, such as conducting puja, havan, playing of the tabla, and pravachan. I would like to thank my Guruji for giving me the opportunity to MC this week's program. Sorry to say that our program has come to an end. Join us next week. Same time, same channel, JC Thurum.